In today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a rapid photo shuffle effect so that way you can start using it in your own videos. And today's video is sponsored by Envato Elements. I'll tell you more about them later on. For now, let's go ahead and jump on in. So here inside of Premiere Pro, I have this folder full of all the photos I want to use. I'm going to open this up by double clicking, and I have it set to the icon view so that way I can easily see all of the photos. And the reason why I like this is that way I can go ahead and move some photos around to rearrange it in the order that I want. And now we need to change the duration of the photo so that way it doesn't default to like 3 seconds each. Select all of them by pressing Command A or Control A, Control click, and then go down to Speed and Duration. And instead of 3 seconds, since this timeline is 24 frames per second, I'm gonna have each photo be a quarter of 24 frames per second, which is 0.8. Press OK. And now, if we drag all of these clips into our timeline, so it goes really fast here. Now, it may not be fast enough. You can certainly change it to 0.4 to make it even faster, but I like 0.8. And the next thing you need to do is just go through quickly on each photo and make sure it's at the right scale. So you'll select the photo, go up to Effect Controls, scale it down, and make sure that the image is fully in view. So now when we play it back, it's rapidly going through the photos, but we need to make it more dynamic. This is where we're gonna go into effects. But first, my name is Kelsey, and welcome back to Premiere Gal. If this video is helping you out so far, be sure to give it a thumbs up as well as subscribe. And if you're looking for some fast photo effects where you don't need to actually go in and animate yourself, but use templates, you can use my link below to get 7 days free of unlimited templates from Envato Elements. I just searched for fast photo shuffle underneath video templates, and over 3,000 templates came up. For example, this fast photo slideshow for After Effects is really cool because it has a really rapid zoom out effect, similar to what we were doing in this video. But if you need a specific software, you can go down here and you can search for After Effects, Premiere Pro, Apple Motion, Final Cut Pro, or DaVinci. If we wanted something for Premiere, for example, we can select that and just go through and see these different types of photo effects that they have here. Now, I put a link below to my favorite photo slideshow templates from Envato Elements, so you can go check that out as well. And of course, you can find more than just photo slideshow templates. If you go to video templates in general, you can see that you can browse by broadcast, packages, elements, infographics, logo stings. They have titles and lower thirds. There's also tons of royalty-free background music and sound effects as well, which is super useful, especially when you're editing videos where you just need to go in and find a sound effect to test out. There's unlimited downloads with Elements, so you can test out as much as you want. And after your 7 days free, if you would like to subscribe to Elements, you can use my link below to get 70% off your first month. All right, thanks so much to Elements for sponsoring today's video. Now let's jump back into the video. So go to the effects panel and search for transform. And this is underneath the distort folder. Double click on transform so it's applied to the first photo. So using the transform effect here, I'm going to animate the scale so it starts bigger and gets smaller. So let's start the scale at 150. Let's type in 150 here next to scale. And then what we need to do is adjust the anchor point. So we can click on this vertical anchor point and move it down so that way it's better in frame. And then we can click on toggle animation. And then at the very end of this photo, we can then bring it back down to 100. And you'll notice there's a little black line at the bottom. We just need to adjust the anchor point slightly down so that disappears. And control click on the last keyframe and choose ease in. So that way it's a bit more smooth of an animation. So what we can do now is copy this clip, Command C, and then lasso and select all of the other clips and right click or control click and select paste attributes. And this time we're just going to paste the transform effects. So the transform effect has now been pasted on all the other photos, and you're going to see that a few of the photos we need to make adjustments on because the transform effect isn't going to fit all the photos because they're all different sizes and image resolutions. So you see here on this photo, we need to make adjustments. So let's select it, go up to effect controls here, and we can adjust the anchor point so it's a little bit lower. So I'm just going to go through quickly and fix the anchor points on all these photos. So now let's play back with that transform zoom effect on each photo. So you can see just adding that slight zoom really added a lot to the photo shuffle effect, but we're not done yet. At this cut point, I want to add a paper flip. So I'm going to go to Envato Elements and I'm going to search for flip paper. So what I'm going to do is download this just by clicking on this icon here, and I'm going to drag it into Premiere Pro. So I have the paper flipping sound effect here. If I double click to open this up, you can see I can play it back. And what I want to do is just isolate one section of the sound effect. So for example, this part, I can press I for in, and here O for out. So now it's just going to be this one paper flip. So I can select this icon, drag audio only, and bring it down here at the cut point. Between these two cuts, we now have that one paper flip. So what I'm going to do is take another section, so that way they don't all sound the same. So I'll take this one, I for in, O for out, and I'll drag this one down at this cut point. So I'll just repeat this quickly for all of the cut points. So here's how it sounds with the paper flips. It sounds pretty good, right? But let's go ahead and add some cool documentary sound effects to this as well. So we go to sound effects and we just search for documentary. I think adding one of these tracks will make it sound even better. For example, this ambience track of Science Exploration. So I'll go ahead and download that, and I already have it imported here, so I'm gonna take this Science Explore ambience track down below, and I'll press C to cut it off here. And then from effects, I will just search for exponential fade, drag and drop this at the end of the clip here, and roll it in so it's not quite as long. Then I'll select this and go to Essential Sound, select Ambience, and I will just reduce this to like minus 16 or 15. So let's see how this sounds. Now this sounds pretty cool, right? Now just to add some frosting on the cake, if we go back to the project panel here, this is completely optional by the way, but I highly suggest doing it because it looks really cool. If you go to New Item and select Color Matte, what we can do is create a black matte and drag it on top of our photos. Select this, then go to Effect Controls, and let's select Create 4-point Polygon Mask. And from here, let's select Invert, and then hover on the corner until you get that rotate icon, press Shift, and let's scale this up. And then from Mask Expansion, we can add little curved edges so it kind of looks more vintage and film-like. And now with the mask on top, we can play it back and it just looks super cool. If you have any other questions, be sure to leave a comment below and I'll go check it out. If you want to learn some more photo effects, you can click to watch more tutorials there. And if you want to check out the presets and templates I have on my store, you can click right over here. That's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.